I had the Alien Gains thing, right? This chest twitch. But it all happened. I was in at a photo shoot in Austria.
Yeah.
And then the guy would make the pictures and stuff, and I would have the cramps. And then I was like, let's do it for a video. Uploads the video, and had in a 1 hour was like 150,000 views, which back in the days was massive, bro. Was,
yeah.
Was big. Yeah. Yeah, it's recording.
Okay, sweet. I think we're good then. All right, sweet. Okay, we're here. Official introduction. This is Joe Sthetics. He decided to, he was able to join me for a podcast, which is awesome. And I'm stoked to get into some, I don't know how much you've talked about some of this stuff before. I don't think I've ever seen you really dig into some of your personal life details and whatnot, some like your history. And I think everyone would love to know that kind of stuff,
yeah.
You know, stuff to do with dating life, you know, where you're born, why you moved to Thailand. I don't know, all that kind of stuff. Like just from the beginning, you were born in Germany, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, first up, hey, everyone, 1 second. Nikki, no music, please.
No worries.
First up, hey, everyone. Like, nice to be in the podcast here with Derek. I mean, obviously, I watch your stuff since ages. Very informative, probably one of the best channels for fitness and bodybuilding. First was more about knowledge. Now you understand a bit more about the entertainment part of the whole thing.
Yeah.
So you make it more interesting and yeah, really cool videos to watch. And yeah, today we're going to talk a bit about whatever you want to touch on. Anything. I'm pretty open with anything. I don't mind talking about, let's say, forbidden topics.
Yeah.
Awesome. I don't mind to say like what I'm doing, mm-hmm. but the truth is some people might be a bit shocked, like, oh my God, why are people doing these things? But it's like, you know, everything is personal choice. I'm like, how can I say, I have a high tolerance for stuff. Some people are using steroids, some people they don't use steroids. It's, you know, that's this is the same thing. Like some people are sexually attracted to this part of the population, some people like this. So people having really different kind of like, what is it called?
Like, I know what you're talking about.
Different
preferences.
How can I say? Yeah. And I wouldn't judge people just based on like some things that you see online. Just real quick. It's always really easy to hate on people and we don't know the background about stuff, right? So by seeing a few videos of someone online that wouldn't really tell you about the background of his life and everything, and maybe this guy is quite humble and everything, but in one video, your reaction is quite weird. So that's why people start easy online to judge. Yeah, the dating life and all that stuff. That's actually a good part because your channel would in the first place be called More Plates, More Dates.
Yeah.
And so it's cool and probably to touch on that. And it's really a good topic to talk about because in Thailand, this is a really good topic to talk about, like in terms of like dating with women and all that stuff. I mean, not that I'm big into this. I have a girlfriend, just to say this real quick, but
I don't think many people even knew that until recently. Like, is this a new thing or what?
To be honest, it's kind of a new thing, man. Holy fuck. But I'm really happy that I have her, to be honest. She helped me a lot with my injury now because my arm was obviously, it was immobilized and stuff. So. Yeah, but I think let's go through the questions. I think you set up a bit of a list with stuff that you wanted to talk about in terms of.
Yeah. I was just interested. Like, you've obviously been traveled a decent amount, and I know you were born in Germany. Like, what was it like living there, and like what compelled you to move to Thailand in the first place? Like, some of that would be good.
So the thing is, I'm from Germany, yeah, but I'm from such a small town in Germany where there's just literally nothing going on much.
Yeah.
Then, so the whole story is like this. So back in the days, I was would work a normal job, like everyone probably like works a normal job. I was learning a technical draftsman in the first place after school, and then I fell out, made some further educations, then worked jobbing here and there, but always like had a hard time with my boss. Always like I always felt like it would better to invest time into myself and do something like. Being self-employed, but yeah. And after that, my Instagram thing went bigger, and that's why when I started to think about like maybe I should do this full time. Maybe
so this was like you were time. Doing the Instagram thing while you were still in Germany working.
So let's start it up more early. So at one point I was doing a competition prep. It was also the first time when I ever took steroids, right? I started the cycle back in the days.
Yeah.
And back in the days also I already had my Instagram. So I just kept posting and documenting the journey of like getting ready, bulking and then off season and then shredding and cutting just for this like one competition, like a road to stage kind of thing.
Yeah.
And then build up my Instagram slowly, but nothing really happened. So build it up, like maybe I made it until 90K something, was stagnating there for a year because I went off cycle as well then, and I was like off for a year, so there was not much going on. But in terms of like posting, I mean, why the heck is someone calling me right now? And yeah, so then I had the Alien Gains thing, right? This chest twitch. But it all happened. I was in at a photo shoot in Austria,
yeah.
And then the guy would make the pictures and stuff, and I would have the cramps. And then I was like, "Let's do it for a video." Uploads the video, and had in a 1 hour was like 150,000 views, which back in the days was massive. Right? Was big. Yeah. Then it went really viral, and it was taking like 3-4 million views. Then on Facebook, people would reshare it, like Lad Bible is a big page.
Oh, yeah.
A Sports Bible, like all these pages on Facebook would reshare it. Like so many people would reshare the video, but without telling it's me or without giving any credits to me. So there was already, when it first posted ever, was already like 20 million views on my neck, which no one knew that it was really me. Anyways, it still made like 150,000 followers from 90 to 150 overnight.
Jesus.
Then I made it until like 200. Yep, that was. Then I kept posting another of these videos, which then also went viral. So I actually posted 3 in a row, which all kind of went viral. After that, the story is like this. I always wanted to make money with that. So I was applying for another job in Berlin, but then I got the job even. But at the same time, body engineers back in the days made an offer to sponsor me as an athlete, which was even more money than the job was paying me, though. So I was like, why the fuck should I? Why should I go with this job when I can do something that I wanted to do anyways, like being an athlete and building my Instagram more?
Mm-hmm.
Then one of my mates from Switzerland was like, "Bruh, come here and we're gonna do this together." And then him was like, "Let's go to Thailand, man." I'm just like, "Yeah, okay." He's like, "It's fucking good, and let's go for 3 months." And it's straight up 3 months, you know. And back in, I was never really in holidays, man, because my parents they always went to holidays when I was at school because my birthday is in January.
Yeah.
And my parents, they have a bricks company. So they, in winter time, they always had kind of free. So they always went to holidays during my birthday. So I was never really traveling much. And then he was like, "Let's go to Thailand, man. 3 months, let's do it." So we are booking in the flight and all that, going to Thailand. And he was just then really ruining the whole relationship because this guy was just keep lying to me. And I was like, "Man, it's about business and we want to push here together and blah, blah." And he would just lie like a holy moly, bro. So I was like, "Fuck this dude," and I'm leaving him. So I went on my own. Bangkok, was there, then met some people, this and that. And that's literally what kicked it off. The real reason that I'm in Thailand is not that something is pretty special there or cool there or whatever. It's only the fact that I was getting there first when I first started to travel. And then I just hit up there and I liked it. And it was warm weather. So it really supported everything that I wanted to do. Create content, do your bodybuilding stuff. And just like living in peace, no one judges you. You can wear whatever the heck you want, man. Here in the Buddhists, bro, they are more open-minded. Like everyone is more tolerant. You know, here in Thailand, they have all these transgenders, people. And it's very wild, man. It's wild, but it's more accepted. So everything is accepted. You could wear a clown costume on the street. People would once look, that's it. But everywhere else in the world, they would look and then judge and then talk shit and all that bullshit. So the vibes in Thailand are really, really good. And then that is really what made me staying here all the time. That is just like, okay, I can do my videos. I can do my training. Then people said, "Yeah, it's because there's such good gear. That's why you're here." I'm just like, right? Big time, not the fact, because it's so much fake stuff as well. So it's not really that people say like, "Yeah, these guys all go to Thailand because they have such good gear there." I would have stayed in another country. I'm not going to say that. But there's better places to be when it comes to gear, definitely.
Yeah. So how many years ago when you did the first trip?
2018. 2018 it was.
Gotcha. Yeah. Okay.
And then since then, it was just always me going back and forward. Because, yeah, I mean, obviously I met some women and when I was there and all that stuff. But nothing that would really hold me back. So I would go to Germany, work, this, and just travel a bit. And I liked it in Thailand. So I was just always going there. But no specific reason, to be honest, like no specific reason. Just one big reason in my small city where I'm from in Germany, it was so bad for me somehow. And I really didn't like it. It's really hard to go get along there. You need a car and nothing is going on. So I was like, why should I waste my time in the city? I can't really even do nice content like with the bodybuilding stuff. And it was really about having a warm environment where it's like you can 24/7 go outside in your underwear, literally, and it's warm, it's nice weather, nice people, nice vibes. And that was what it was all about. That's the reason why I went. And then 2018, yep, then just like I said, go to Germany, stay there a bit, come back, and then just always traveled. I've been in Bali and Singapore and like Vietnam and around Asia. I've never been to the US, which I need to do.
Yeah.
And that's literally it. Yeah. And Canada is where I want to
go. Yeah. Hopefully the travel restrictions are not too insane, because definitely want to make that happen soon. For Gorilla Mind as well as Young LA, that would be a good collaboration for sure. So you've been like to, I guess you went to Dubai recently too. Like how do some of the different places compare, like Thailand versus Dubai versus
I have a very good comparison when it comes to this.
Okay.
Let's say Dubai is almost like